Hello, it's me, Foul Prince, your good friend and neighbour, with a little introduction to the video you're about to see and what you can expect from it, because it is a little bit different. I think you'll see. When I was in the hospital recently, I was terribly, terribly bored. And boredom is not a good condition, especially combined with my incredible laziness. So I decided the quickest way to get out of being bored was to throw together a video for you beautiful people. However, I wasn't able to do that for two reasons. One, I'd had pipes down my throat for so long, my voice was all over. And I'd already done a Tom Waits video, and a video of me sounding like Tom Waits probably wasn't going to be that entertaining. And the other one was the medication they'd put me on had given me the horrible shakes, which is why I got the beard. I couldn't be trusted with a razor for weeks afterwards. So in any case, I thought, why not get AI to put together a video for me? So I did. I used a couple of programs, and the results, as you'll see coming up, are quite curious. I'm always abused by the accent that the AI has chosen to give me. It's gotten my cadence and my stanchion absolutely right, but the varying accent across it is remarkable. Anyway, I've got me and a few of my celebrity friends to get together and make this video for you, which is The Past is a Foreign Country, number 59. The airwaves filled with pop songs bright and gay. In 62, the British started to sway, with Elvis still a king upon his throne. The Beach Boys sang of surfing on their own, and girls swooned over Cliff's honey-sweet tone. The pop world was blissfully unaware that a bunch of yobs in the northwest of England would, during the course of the year, pick up a new drummer and pull apart the very world they lived in, which on January 7th, 1962, looked like it would stand forever. 10 Contiki by the Shadows is a guitar-driven masterpiece that showcases the band's incredible musicianship and innovative sound. The track's driving rhythm, upbeat tempo, and catchy melody make it a standout in the genre of instrumental rock, with its instantly recognizable opening riff instantly transporting listeners to a sun-soaked beach in the 1960s. The song's key of E minor and brisk tempo give it a sense of urgency and excitement, while the band's expert use of dynamics and phrasing create a sense of tension and release that keeps the listener engaged throughout. The structure of the song is also notable, with its use of a recurring riff and simple chord progression providing a framework for the band's virtuosic guitar playing. Despite their immense contributions to the world of music, the Shadows have yet to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. This is a great injustice, as the band's innovative sound and groundbreaking approach to instrumental rock have had a profound impact on the genre and continue to inspire musicians around the world to this day. Nine. Two instrumentals kick us off, then with Takefive by the Davebrubeck Quartet, an exceptional piece of jazz music that showcases the unparalleled musical talents of its members. The track's signature 5/4-time signature and catchy melody have made it one of the most recognizable jazz tunes of all time. From the very first note, it's clear that Brubeck and his quartet are masters of their craft. The interplay between Brubeck's piano and Paul Desmond's saxophone is nothing short of brilliant, and the rhythm section of Eugene Wright and Joe Morello provide a solid foundation for the song's unique structure. What makes Take Five so special is the way it seamlessly blends together elements of jazz, classical music, and world music. Brubeck's use of unusual time signatures and modes, combined with Desmond's inventive phrasing, creates a sound that is both sophisticated and accessible. 8. Gene McDaniel's Tower of Strength is a soulful and powerful track that showcases the immense vocal talents of this legendary singer-songwriter. McDaniel's smooth, velvety voice delivers the song's poignant lyrics with a sincerity and emotion that is truly captivating. Born in Kansas City, Missouri in 1935, McDaniel's began his career as a member of doo-wop group The Echoes before striking out on his own as a solo artist. He quickly made a name for himself in the world of R&B with hits like 100 Pounds of Clay and Point of No Return, and his soulful voice and thought-provoking lyrics have since become synonymous with the genre. Tower of Strength is a perfect example of what makes McDaniel such a standout performer. The song's powerful lyrics, coupled with McDaniel's soulful delivery, create a moving and deeply affecting experience that stays with the listener long after the track has ended. At number 7, Run to Him by Bobby V is a timeless classic that showcases the singer's smooth and soulful voice, backed by a simple but effective arrangement of guitar and drums. The song's catchy melody and heartfelt lyrics make it an instant favorite, with its message of love and support resonating with listeners of all ages. Released in 1961, Run to Him quickly became a chart-topping hit, reaching the hash 2 spot on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 and staying on the charts for over 15 weeks. The song's popularity was not limited to the U.S., however, as it also reached the top 10 in the Australian charts, where it remained a favorite of audiences for years to come. What makes Run to Him such a standout track is its timeless appeal. The song's themes of love, support, and devotion are universal, and V's smooth vocal delivery is as captivating today as it was over 60 years ago. With its catchy melody and memorable lyrics, Run to Him is a classic pop song that continues to resonate with music lovers around the world. Big Bad John by Jimmy Dean is a classic country ballad that tells the story of a man named John who works in a coal mine and saves his fellow miners from a collapse before ultimately sacrificing himself in the process. The song's narrative is delivered in Dean's signature baritone voice, accompanied by a simple but effective arrangement of guitar, drums, and harmonica. While Big Bad John may not be everyone's cup of tea, it's hard to deny the song's lasting impact on the country music genre. The song's simple but powerful storytelling, coupled with Dean's smooth vocal delivery, create a moving and memorable experience for listeners. The track's use of sound effects, such as the sound of the mine collapsing and John's voice echoing through the caverns, also add a sense of depth and texture to the narrative. While some may find the song's themes of sacrifice and heroism to be a bit heavy-handed, there's no denying the emotional impact of John's selfless act and the song's overall message of standing up for one's fellow man. Ultimately, Big Bad John is a classic country ballad that continues to resonate with audiences to this day, and a must-listen for anyone who appreciates the genre. At 5, Can't Help Falling in Love by Elvis Presley is a timeless classic that has stood the test of time since its release in 1961. The song's gentle melody and heartfelt lyrics make it a standout in Presley's impressive catalog of hits. The track's use of a simple yet effective arrangement of guitar and strings creates a sense of intimacy and tenderness that perfectly complements Presley's smooth and soulful vocal delivery. The song's history is also notable as it has been featured in numerous films and concert performances over the years. Most famously, Can't Help Falling in Love was featured in Presley's 1961 film Blue Hawaii and has since been covered by countless artists and used in various TV shows, films, and commercials. In concert, Presley often used Can't Help Falling in Love as his closing number, with audiences around the world singing along to the song's memorable chorus. The track's enduring popularity is a testament to its timeless appeal and Presley's lasting influence on the world of music.
Hey there, ladies and gentlemen. It's the King Baby coming at you with the latest chart news. Now listen up, because we got some exciting updates for you. So put on your blue suede shoes and join me for the ride of a lifetime. It's time to rock and roll. We got a whole lot of action happening this week at Heartbreak Hotel, and we're going to take a look at the new faces in town and the hits that are making a comeback, like I did in 69. It's like one for the money, two for the show, and three to get ready for goodbye and hello. First up, we got the newcomers strutting their stuff and making their mark. These are the ones who are ready to take the stage and steal your heart. Keep an eye out, y'all, because they're about to make some fun in Acapulco. First off, let me introduce my close personal friend Bobby V with his hit song Run to Him. This fantastic tune has made a remarkable climb from 16 all the way up to 7. And mark my words, it's bound for number 2. You see, it can't be number 1 because I'm number 1, baby. That's right, the king is here to stay. Then there's Texas Boy, Jimmy Dean, and his incredible track, Big Bad John. This song, which was once a chart topper, has made a grand comeback and reclaimed its position in the top 10 from a low of 14. It's risen like a phoenix. Speaking of Jimmy Dean, did you know he appeared in a James Bond film called Diamonds Are Forever? He played the billionaire Willard White. Can you believe it? They made a Bond film in Vegas, recast the lead, and didn't call me for the role. I mean, come on, man, I owned Vegas. I was the king of that town. But let's get back to the main attraction, which is yours truly, the king. My song, Can't Help Falling in Love, is heating things up on the charts. It's on the rise, climbing from 12 to 5, and it's well on its way to claim the number one spot. It's the biggest hunk of burning wax this week, I'll hep you to that. Well, hillbilly cats and kittens, let me fill you in on the songs that have returned to sender. Now, I gotta admit, some of these names might be new to me too, but hey, let's give them a fair shake. Now we got Bobby Edwards with his tune, You're the Reason. Now I can't say I've heard of him before, but his song fell from its highest position of 5 down to 11. Tough break, Bobby, but keep on rocking. Your king commands you. Next on the list, we got Sandy Nelson with his groovy track, Let There Be Drums. Unfortunately, it seems like the rhythm ran out of time for Sandy. The song slipped from 8 down to 14. Keep those sticks drumming, Sandy! And last but not least, we got Dion and his big hit, Run Around Sue. Now, Dion's a good, good buddy of mine, and it's a shame to see his song drop from 10 to 17. Bummer. But hold on tight, hound dogs, because the next number one is yet to come. It's just around the corner, ready to take over the countdown next week, so keep those ears open and get ready to groove to the sound of the new chart topper. Thank you very much. That's all right, Mama, and that's all for now.
So, looking at the 10 this week, it's all pretty good, but there is one weak link, and that's that ode to toxic masculinity, which is, of course, the best kind of masculinity, Big Bad John. Kind of flat, a bit of a reactionary novelty hit, but what is there lurking in the nether bottoms of the charts that might replace it and make a superior top 10? Well, it's none other than the great one herself, the magnificent Patsy Cline with the Willie Nelson penned Crazy, which we were crazy enough to let get no higher than 21. I mean, really, it's Patsy for crying out loud.
In at 4, it's Cliff. When the Girl in Your Heart is the Girl in Your Arms by Cliffrichard is a classic pop ballad that showcases Richard's smooth and soulful vocal delivery. The song's gentle melody and heartfelt lyrics create a sense of intimacy and romance that has made it a fan favorite over the years. In the early 1960s, Cliffrichard was one of the biggest pop stars in the world, with a string of hits that dominated the charts in the UK, Australia, and beyond. His popularity in Australia in particular was immense, with his tours drawing huge crowds and his music receiving regular airplay on local radio stations. 3. James Darren's Goodbye Cruel World is a song that's as catchy as it is dark. The track's upbeat tempo and sing-along chorus create an ironic contrast to its lyrics, which are all about bidding farewell to the world in a fit of existential despair. It's a bit like if the Beach Boys decided to cover a Joy Division song. James Darren, the man behind the music, is a singer, actor, and director who got his start in the entertainment industry in the late 1950s. He's perhaps best known for his role as Moondoggy in the classic surfing movie Gidget, as well as his appearances on TV shows like The Time Tunnel and TJ Hooker. He also had a successful music career with hits like Her Royal Majesty and Conscience. But it's Goodbye Cruel World that really stands out as one of Darren's most unique and memorable tracks. The song's playful melody and tongue-in-cheek lyrics make it a favorite among fans of dark humor and irony. It's the perfect song to put on when you're feeling a bit down in the dumps and need a good laugh. In at number 2, The Lion Sleeps Tonight by The Tokens is a masterpiece that has stood the test of time. Originally a traditional Zulu song called Mbube, The Tokens adapted it and gave it new life with their upbeat and catchy pop version that was released in 1961. The song quickly became a worldwide hit and has since become an iconic song of the 1960s. One of the most interesting aspects of The Lion Sleeps Tonight is its African origins. The song's lyrics, which describe a lion sleeping peacefully in the jungle, reflect the deep respect and admiration that African cultures have for nature and its creatures. The Tokens' version of the song features intricate vocal harmonies and African-inspired rhythms, which perfectly capture the spirit of the original Zulu song.
It's Phil's Fantastic World of Facts.
Folks, let me tell you, the tremendous success story of the week goes to none other than Rock a Hula Baby by the one and only Elvis Presley. Now, this incredible hit was originally the B-side of Can't Help Falling in Love. But let me tell you something, and boy, did it make a splash. It jumped all the way from 37 to 25. That's what I call a winner. But let's talk about failure. Run Around Sue by Dion. Oh boy, what a tumble it took. It dropped like Joe Biden off a bicycle. From a promising 10, it fell all the way down to 17. That's a big letdown, let me tell you. Now let's talk about the highest debutante, When I Fall in Love by the Letterman. It burst onto the scene like a firecracker, entering the charts at an impressive number 35. That's how you make an entrance without a convenient escalator. And here's something interesting. We had two discs that shared the longest run on the chart. First, we have the great Roy Orbison from the town of Wink, Texas, with his sensational hit, Crying. That song has been on the chart for a whopping 16 weeks. And let's not forget about Australia's very own legend, Johnny O'Keefe from Bondi Junction. His hit, I'm Counting on You, has also been holding strong for 16 weeks. That's what I call staying power. So There you have it, the latest chart updates, just the way you like it. Big winners like me, big losers like Crooked Hillary, and incredible talent lighting up the charts. Stay tuned for more because we're just getting started.
Now let's spend some time with the monk who lays down the funk and steps back from the junk. Here with this week's number one is Monty the Safety Monkey. Be your own bad self, Monty.
Ah, Charlie Drake's My Boomerang Won't Come Back. A true artifact of its time, but one that has raised some eyebrows in recent years due to its rather, shall we say, questionable lyrics. Yes, it's true that the song includes some language and imagery that would be considered culturally insensitive by today's standards, but let's not forget that it was created during a time when such attitudes were unfortunately commonplace in popular culture. We can't judge a piece of art solely on the basis of modern sensibilities. At the same time, however, we must acknowledge that the song's lyrics do contain some problematic elements, and we should be careful not to excuse or downplay the harm that such language can cause. That being said, it's worth noting that My Boomerang Won't Come Back is also a catchy and well-crafted piece of music with a playful melody and a clever use of language. Charlie Drake was a talented performer who knew how to get a laugh, and this song is a testament to his skill in that regard. Ultimately, then, any evaluation of My Boomerang Won't Come Back must take into account both its strengths and its flaws, and we must strive to understand it in its proper cultural context. We can appreciate the song for its entertainment value while also recognizing the problematic elements in its lyrics, and we can use it as a starting point for broader conversations about the history and impact of cultural insensitivity in popular culture.
And if the good Lord's willing and the creeks don't rise, we'll be back with another installment next week. Ish.